In this video, we're going to show you how to replace a front wheel bearing on your Honda Pilot. Let's get started. Using a 19 millimeter socket, remove the 5 lug nuts. Remove the wheel. Using a 17 millimeter socket, remove the caliper bracket bolts. Remove the bolts. Remove the caliper from the rotor. Using a flat blade screwdriver to help me pry this caliper off. Our caliper is stuck. Yours should not come off this hard. Once I have the caliper off, I'm going to flip it up and hang it on my hook. Hang the hook on the strut. Hang the caliper from the hook. Make sure there's no pressure on this line while it's hanging. Using a Phillips head screwdriver, we're going to remove the rotor screws from this rotor. Remove the rotor screws. Remove the rotor. Using a 36 millimeter socket, remove the axle nut. Make sure that the axle moves freely inside of the hub. Using a 21 millimeter socket, remove the nut off the tie rod end. Using a mallet, hit around the outside of here to break the tie rod end free. Remove the tie rod from the knuckle. Remove the cotter pin out of the ball joint. Using a 19 millimeter wrench, loosen the ball joint nut. Remove the ball joint nut. Separate the ball joint from the knuckle. I'm going to be using a ball joint removal tool. Separate the ball joint using a pry bar with a hook, and we're going to hook the hook around the lower control arm. We're going to pry down, pulling the lower ball joint out of the knuckle. As we're pulling down, we're going to swing our knuckle forward. As we swing our knuckle forward, we're going to push our axle in so the boot or the axle does not come separated inside of the boot. Using a 24 millimeter wrench to hold the head of the bolt, we're going to use a 22 millimeter socket to remove the nut. Do the same thing on the lower bolt. To remove the bolts from the car, we're going to push on the hub, kind of wiggle. I like to remove the bottom first, then push and pull the top out. With all of your bolts out, you may need a small pry bar to pry on the top of the knuckle, pull it out of the strut. Using a 10 millimeter socket, remove the bolt for the ABS sensor. Remove the bolt for the ABS sensor. We're going to use a pair of pliers and go around the ABS sensor. And we're going to try and twist this side to side until it starts to wiggle freely. It may help you to have the tie rod end in. Our sensor is stuck in this knuckle, so we're going to cut the wire right here. And we're going to replace this ABS sensor when we're done with this job. If your sensor comes out, wiggle it, pull it straight out, and put it off to the side. We're going to pull the tie rod back out of the knuckle. We're going to remove the knuckle. We're going to push the axle in through the hub. We're going to put the axle off to the side. And since this was broken free, if it reseats, it should be pretty easy to take off, just like that. And remove the knuckle. We're going to remove the hub from the wheel bearing and knuckle assembly. To do this, we're going to use one hammer that has a bit of a cone shape on the back side of the hub, and we're going to use a second hammer to hit it. We have the knuckle set up in a vise, and I have a barrel on the floor set up where I think that this hub is going to go. Remove the hub. You don't want to damage these threads at all, so be sure that this doesn't hit the ground or anything that might damage the studs. Using a pair of snap ring pliers, remove the snap ring. I'm going to use a round-off socket and hammer it onto the top of the screw. And remove the screw. We're going to do the same thing for the next two. The head of that bolt snapped off. Using a pair of snap ring pliers, remove the snap ring. Remove the bolt, and we should be able to remove our backing plate. This one's going to be pretty rusted on. I'm going to use a flat blade screwdriver and a hammer. We're going to tap this off, go around and get it all removed. Remove the backing plate, and then we're going to clean up this surface. Using a wire brush, we're going to clean up the knuckle surface. Using a cutoff tool, we're going to cut the inner race off of the hub. While doing this, you want to make sure that you don't cut the hub at all. We're going to get mostly through this race, and I'm going to use a punch and a hammer, and we're going to split this. Once you split the race, it should slide right off. The reason we put a punch in there and rather crack it instead of cut all the way through is if you cut all the way through, there's a much higher chance of you hitting the hub. With our knuckle set up in a press, we're going to press out the wheel bearing. Remove the wheel bearing from the knuckle. With the knuckle and bearing set up in the press, we'll press the wheel bearing into the knuckle. Press in the bearing until it bottoms out. Using a pair of snap ring pliers, we're going to install the snap ring into the knuckle. I'm going to be using a hammer and a flathead to help me seat this. install the backing plate onto the knuckle. Give it a good push down. And then get the bolt started. We only have two bolts for ours. You should have three on yours. Snug the bolts down. Now we're ready to press the hub in. When we press the hub into our bearing, we're gonna hold this inside race. This is the only part you're gonna wanna hold. If you hold anything else, you're gonna just push this inner race out. That's what ours will look like. With our hub set up in the press, we'll press it into the bearing. Keep going until it bottoms out. And the knuckle is ready to go back on the car. Install the knuckle onto the lower control arm. We're gonna get the nut started on the lower control arm ball joint. We're gonna put our axle, line it up with the hub. Then we're going to push the knuckle back into the strut. Line up the bolt holes and get your bolt started. I like to do the bottom first. Makes the top one easy. Just push at the top. Grab the nuts for the knuckle bolts and get them started. Install the outer tie rod into the knuckle. We're gonna thread on our nut. Install the nut onto the outer tie rod and snug it down. Tighten the bolts for the knuckle. Torque the two knuckle bolts to 116 foot-pounds. Tighten the ball joint nut. Torque the ball joint nut to 51 foot-pounds. If you can't get a torque wrench in here, do the best you can. Once you have the ball joint nut torqued, you can go up to an additional 60 degrees or until the slot in the castle nut lines up with a hole in the stud, and then install your cotter pin. Bend the cotter pin over. And if you'd like, you can chop off the extra ends. Install the ABS sensor into the knuckle. And get the bolt started. Snug the bolt down. Install the axle nut. Snug it down. Using a pry bar to hold the studs on the hub, we're gonna torque the axle nut to 210 foot-pounds. Using a hammer and a punch, stake the axle nut. Install the rotor onto the car. Install the rotor screws. grab your caliper off the hook and install it onto the rotor. Torque the caliper bracket bolts to 80 foot-pounds. Install the wheel, get the 5 lug nuts started. Snug them down. Torque your wheels to 80 foot-pounds in a star pattern. Once you're done with this job, take your car to a local shop and have them do an alignment.
When only the best will do, demand TRQ, the only company that lets you view before you do. TRQ is committed to offering the highest quality aftermarket auto parts that are engineered for peace of mind. Thanks for using and viewing with TRQ.